As a Power BI developer or lead, you're tasked with performing one of the most business-critical steps within an ETL or ELT pipeline, which is converting the millions of records across hundreds of tables in your warehouse into usable, accessible metrics and data points to drive business decisions. With such responsibilities comes a host of issues across multiple dimensions with regards to even a single report page. We at Datagaps see these problems every day across multiple industries and architectures, and so we have summarized the latest trends. The KPIs and graphs in these reports are the most critical aspects of the entire pipeline and have to be blindly trusted by the end users. Making sure that these KPIs are accurate is paramount. These could be backed up against the data warehouse, the end-to-end data model, or even a dedicated Excel file. Alternatively, one can use past records, numbers, or even rules to validate the latest report. However, there's a catch. The KPIs are subject to user access levels and filter combinations, and the reports are the aggregation of multiple sources. Therefore, a discrepancy in one of the sources could be covered up when combined with the rest. Thus, the accuracy of the KPIs and graphs is to be validated not just with the default unfiltered version, but also with multiple combinations of filters that the users might use. Another aspect of BI validation is ensuring consistency for the end user. This takes form in ensuring the standardization of reports in terms of report layout, filter or slicer definitions, font families, color schemes, and much more. This standardization comes into effect for both cross-environment, that is between your development, QA, and production, as well as cross-versions, that is between your multiple versions of your reports before and after upgrades or updates. Catching the unintended changes across the entire dashboard becomes the real challenge. The additional challenge comes in form of consistency in the user access level and role level security, ensuring that the intended user groups have access to the expected reports on an ongoing basis, and keeping regular validation checks on the same is an industry agnostic problem statement. The next problem is something a lot of QA personnel are tasked with without any pointers or leads. The reports should be fast and responsive for our huge user base, as we expect. That is, report performance. There are two main facets here. The first one is to keep track of the loading times and responsiveness of a report over the course of upgrades and updates. The other is to test the BI server itself and see if it can handle the surge of users trying to access a subset of reports simultaneously. The loading times and responsiveness here are the metrics the QA looks for. Optimization and, more importantly, the validation of optimization of Power BI reports have seen an increase in the recent times. From our perspective at Datagaps, we have also noticed a trend of organizations shifting their BI tools or consolidating their BI tools into Power BI as a single shop. We have seen migrations from Tableau, SSRS, Oracle Analytics, and more into Power BI. Needless to say, this is a huge undertaking. All the major pointers that we have discussed so far come into play at really large scales. We are talking thousands of reports moving platforms. Here, data validation, transformation validation, filter validation, layout validation, performance validation, and security validation are absolutes. And the need for automation is center. Not just for a migration project, but also for any dashboard management. The need to automate validation, monitoring, notifications, and reporting is critical to keep away the issues that come with manual validation with its effort and effectiveness. In summary, accuracy, consistency, and performance remain the most important aspects for a Power BI developer or a QA tester to deal with. However, BI migration projects have seen a sharp rise as well. To know more on how to effectively deal with these type of issues, contact us at Datagaps.